In plants, water enters through the roots, while atmospheric carbon dioxide enters through openings in the leaves called stomata. Oxygen and water are released by the plant through these same openings. Photosynthesis takes place within the leaves in specialized organelles called chloroplasts. The basic process of photosynthesis can be summarized using the equation shown here. Carbon dioxide, water, and light energy combine to yield the products of sugar, oxygen, and water. Of course, knowing the reactants and products does not tell us the specific nature of the photosynthetic reactions that take place. For example, where does the oxygen that's released into the atmosphere by plants come from? Does it come from the carbon dioxide or from the water? This question was answered in the 1940s by Samuel Rubin and colleagues at UC Berkeley using isotopes of oxygen. The common isotope of oxygen is oxygen-16. By using the oxygen-18 heavy isotope of oxygen to label either the carbon dioxide or water reactants, the source of the oxygen released into the atmosphere can be determined. Let's begin by labeling the carbon dioxide reactant with the oxygen-18 isotope. Our data will consist of the 0:18:0:16 isotope ratio measured in the evolved oxygen as compared to the starting ratio in the CO2 reactant, an unlabeled H2O. Note that not all of the CO2 will contain the heavy isotope. Now let's repeat the experiment by labeling the H2O reactant. Again, our data will consist of the 0:18:0:16 isotope ratio measured in the evolved oxygen as compared to the starting ratio in the H2O reactant. What can we conclude from this experiment? Is the source of oxygen released by the plants derived from the carbon dioxide or water reactants? When CO2 was labeled with 18O, none of the oxygen released was labeled. However, when 0:18 labeled water was used as a reactant, the oxygen released was labeled with a heavy isotope. Therefore, the source of the oxygen in the O2 released by the plant is water.